Hello, everybody. It is 12:48, Friday, December 29th. I'm on my way to Cincinnati, Ohio. Just had the oil changed and everything here in the truck, so new light bulb put in. Everything's done. It's all good to go. And they told me at the office that it's real slow over there, so I'm going to get checked into a room now. And had a brother in Christ, you know, just came right out and helped me today. Just awesome. Awesome. You know, made it to where, because it's slow. It's snowing right now, too. Just starting to snow. But they told me to go to Cincinnati and wait out there. Probably they said after Monday it would be better. And so I can get a room now until Monday, actually, till Tuesday. So when things should be back on the board like they should be. But you guys, you know, we're waiting every moment like it could be any moment. And you know how I said the Lord does, he works through us, you know, through one another. And that's why I say it's so important, you guys, that we stay focused on Jesus Christ throughout what we're doing right now. This time is going to be over before you know it, you guys. The Lord said to watch, and everything that we read, we're going to be doing some serious reading these next couple days too, you guys. I found some more writings that I had in the pamphlet, which I'm going to take up to the room with me. Remember these things, okay? God, he created evil for the day of evil, that we're in the day of evil now, to do what it's going to do. And then he said, those that trusted him, we don't have to fear. We have power over that. But he said, don't gloat in that. Rejoice that our name is in the book of life. That's where we should be rejoicing. And that's for those that believe and that are aware. And so many people are not aware. I just got through sharing with this other guy. I couldn't tell where his nationality was from. It could be Europe. I don't know. But I pulled out the photo on my camera with the angel blowing the trumpet over my head and a video. And he's seen the spirits and he goes, what is that? And he went into me and I said, these are the spirits. Our bodies are a host. And he's going, bro, I said, it's in the Bible. It says this. Everything that you see, it's in the Bible. And he's seen both of them. And then when I came up and I paused on that photo, I said, can you see the angel above my head? And he's going, yes. And I said, do you notice that it's blowing a trumpet? And he's going, yes. And he goes, I see it. I could see it. I said, now get in touch with me. I'll give you my email address. And I'm going to send you this photo. And you can show it to other people. And you're going to find that many people can't see it. And I said, and you've seen it very easily. I could tell. I didn't even have to describe anything to you. And I said, that's because of the spirit that's in you. And I think this is something the Holy Spirit that's in you makes you see what they can't see. This is big, you guys. It's very big. And this is where I say we're truly blessed, you guys, to know what we know. And that's why I'm saying we got to really stay focused, because it's in the Bible. It says, redeem this time, strengthen what remains. Then he says, if you don't follow me, you're not worthy of me. And if you don't love me first, you're not worthy of me. So what should we be doing? Also, knowing that this place is reserved for fire, it's going to be burnt to a cinder. Shouldn't we be as close to Christ as we possibly can? And who cares about all these other vain teachings? You know, because everything we need to know is in the Bible. We don't need to know. You don't have to prove to me that we're in the last days. I know we're in the last days. You know? Therefore, let's draw close to Christ, you know, and stay close to Christ. That's why you guys see me on this channel when people are bringing in all this other stuff and just a little things here and there, and they're constantly trying to twist things. And then they're trying to keep you so busy in different things, they're trying to come on this channel and cause a lot of distractions is what they're doing. They don't intertalk with any of us. They don't. All they do is they try to send up things, different things, whatever they can do to be a distraction. You know, we are in the high times right now, you guys. I told you over a year ago that I had a dream that when this time comes closer for us to leave, that they are going to do this, okay? Therefore, all we have to do is keep drawing closer to Christ. You know, remember, we are a member of the body of Christ. That's the only thing that we should be doing. Nothing else matters, you guys. Nothing. I'm serious, okay? Nothing. You know, he's showing us signs right now. He told us to watch. You guys have seen those spirits moving around? That's the Lord revealing them, not me. You know, and the picture, that's the Lord revealing it, not me. Everything I've been showing you guys, man, it speaks in volumes. There's nothing more we need to know. Jesus Christ is coming for us, man. We're in the body of Christ, and who cares about everything else? You know, when I watch other people's channels, I'll watch them, but if they're not constantly, like, in Christ, glorifying in Christ, you know, his name should forever be on our lips, glorifying Christ in everything and all things that we do. So if they're going to these other teachings and it has nothing to do with glorifying Christ here and now, you know, sometimes we might talk about something, but man, it better be leading you to Christ, in Christ, about Christ. You know, because when we read our Bible, man, that's what it all talks about. All the disciples, man, it's all about Christ. Don't let people lead you away. I had a dream about that too, where I was like on a little dinghy raft or whatever, and somebody in a yacht pulled me out into the ocean, and then it's like they just left me stranded out there. And then alligators surfaced up all around me, you know. And I'm like, hey, hey, I'm yelling inside, go buy your oil from those that sell. You know, and I think that's what that saying means. Stay with Christ. Don't mess with all this other stuff. There's a lot of vain teachings out there, you guys. And remember, they said they'd deceive the very elect if they could. If they're not constantly praising on their lips Jesus Christ, you know, be checking all things. Remember, he said, test all spirits. You know, don't put somebody on a pedestal because you think they live in a nice home and all that stuff. Don't do it. You know, you'll know them by their fruits. You know, look, man, I'm getting ready to go check into a room right now down in Orlando. Or not Orlando, but Cincinnati. Brother in Christ just reached out and helped today, you know. Told me not to take off. I was going to go to Indianapolis, Indiana. And they said to go down here, but they said it's going to be slow probably even on Monday because of the holiday. And I said, well, I said, just take me out the books. I said, no sense to be sitting in the truck freezing to death. And if I rent this room, I can't, you know, I'm not, you know, they won't give me a refund. So just take me off and I'm going to go do that. Yeah, do this, what we're doing here. Sure, comfort, edify. You know, get out of this cold for a few days. You know, it's going to be nice. You know, who knows? We might be gone by then, you guys. Never know. We need to be in Christ, though. Remember, in the body of Christ. Because remember, when he's going to raise us up, those that are in Christ, you know, they're trying real hard to lead you away into all this different stuff. And they're trying to distract us from constantly praising Jesus Christ. God bless you guys. I will be talking to you guys live as soon as I get down there to the room, okay? And I even got me a new backpack, man. So, you know, the other one's kind of tearing and stuff, and I was just waiting for it, you know. But I got a new one here, so I'm going to transfer all my stuff into that. And, man, the Lord's great. Thank you, Jesus.